Quentin Ratata pour la première et j'espère pas pour la dernière fois. Young Blood!
It's a duet on the album. Thanks,
it's a duet.
First of all, thanks a lot for being our guest.
Thank you for having me, man.
Really, really. I've heard your material. And I just ask everybody on this set, in this team, I said, should we have this guy? Can we have this guy? Well, we're gonna ask. And you say yes.
So, absolutely, you're joking.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. So, it's a duet. Tell us about this duet with Dan Reynolds, Imagine Dragons.
It was a bit of a mental situation because I was in New Orleans in America and Dan Reynolds from Imagine Dragons rings me up. He's like, hello, it's Dan Reynolds from Imagine Dragons. I'm like, yeah, fuck off, whatever. Bang.
So you didn't believe that?
And then he calls back.
Okay.
And says,
so he insists.
It's really Dan Reynolds. And I'm like, what? And he's like, I love what you're doing. I love your music. Do you want to do a song together?
So it's from, I mean, it's him, the first, asking you for a duet.
He was just like, I love what you're doing. We should get in the studio. I was like, yeah.
Okay, so at that point, did he have a song for the duet?
Yeah, man, he had the bass line.
You co-write this song
yes,
together?
Yes, he had the bum, ba, bum, bum, ba, bum, 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 bum. And I was like, sick.
C'est bien, c'est cool, ça commence bien. I love that. So, I mean, the video clip is just amazing. Le clip, regardez-le sur internet, ça se passe dans une espèce de casse automobile où dès qu'il y en a un qui chante, il y a une voiture qui arrive au-dessus et qui l'écrase pour que l'autre vienne chanter et ainsi de suite. It's kind of quite destroying people in
yeah,
this
man.
Video clip.
Yeah. But no one was harmed in the making of
no,
it, I promise.
No, even with the car on you, you can get out of this car.
That was like the metaphor of the song. It's like, no matter how many times the world or people are gonna try and crush you or oppress you or put you down, just keep getting back up, man, and it'll all be all right. Do you know what I mean?
Hey, joli message. You're not a loser. What do you say? I'm an original loser. How come the idea of, well, do you think people try to, like you say, press you down or destroy you
and
make you feel that you are a loser?
When I grew up, I was from somewhere that was really like industrial.
Doncaster.
Doncaster in the north of England. And
22 years ago.
22 years ago. And I don't know, man. They are very set in their ways, and I look like this.
You're not born like this.
No, I promise you.
It's not a proper size, definitely you have to wear something else.
But I was just like into painting my nails and wearing makeup, and where I was from, people didn't like that. And it was hard for me because when your brain tells you to go somewhere, and people say, no, 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 you're not supposed to do that. It forces you to question yourself and go, hang on a second, is the way I'm feeling and thinking wrong? So my sole aim as Youngblood and like with my family. I don't call my fan base, I call my family. I can literally see some people here tonight. Like I can see them. And
that's your fans?
Family, community. Okay. And it's a place where you can be whoever the fuck you want to be without judgment.
So this judgment, when you say people tell you when you were a little boy, you don't have to wear this, you don't have to behave this way and stuff like that. Was it as cool as that or a little bit more aggressive?
For
some moment, did they insult you or
all the time.
Hurt you?
All the time. I got called many names, a freak, a reject. People just didn't understand the way I thought. I remember one time, someone who worked in my school got so mad at me and was just like, why can't you be just like everybody else? And I remember looking at him in the face. I was like, I don't want to be like everybody else. And then I was just like, I love Oscar Wilde, man. He said, like, don't be everyone else because everyone else is taken, right? Be yourself. And I want to give people a space to feel free to be whoever they want to be.
Do you remember the day where you decide to be free, to be yourself, to behave like you want to behave?
Yeah.
Is it through the music, through the acting? Because you wish to be an actor at the real beginning, no?
I mean, I was just whatever. I just love showing off, man. Do you know what I mean?
Showing off or being somebody else? Because acting is that, being somebody else.
Do you know what? You might have actually... I should come to you for therapy, shouldn't I? because I think that was part of my head, to be honest. I was like, I enjoyed Halloween. And I enjoyed the Joker. And I enjoyed, like, dark characters. Because I get to put makeup on and no one would, like, punch me. You know what I mean? So I was like, oh, I feel good here. I feel good here.
You weren't looking for sweets at all?
No, man.
No, just freaking people.
Everyone else was giving me sweets. I was like, why are you giving me sweets, man? I just feel good. And I moved out of London. And I kind of figured out the world for myself. I think when you kind of take off the rose-tinted glasses that people place upon you and see the world for the first time, I just said, I'm going to be myself because I'm so sick of being somebody else.
So in your lyrics, in your songs, do you tell your own story or is it testimonies or maybe the Black Hearts stories, what you heard from others, I mean, other story around you? How comes as lyrics?
I think with it, it's a mix of everything. Initially, it came from me. It was so much about me at first when I had this explosion of, this is who I am. Are you out there? And then a lot of people was like, yes, I am. I feel like you. And at first, I was just like, whoa. And then the material became about us and it became less about me. And it became about if you feel like you belong nowhere or you feel like you can't be who you are, then come here because we feel exactly like that. But together, we can be who we are.
So parents, for instance, is it about your family?
That song, it's not me telling your parents to fuck off. I'm not that... It's a tribute to individualism.
Okay.
It's a story that...
You've been told? This story you've been told?
By everyone, like everyone I've ever met. A 50-year-old man came up to me at the show called Gaz in London this year and was like, I relate to that song so much. And I was like, what? Sick.
That's the story of a father telling his son, if you ever kiss another boy, I'll kill you.
Yeah, that is like so many, I hear so many stories of that. And I just can't believe that people get angry about love. Like to me, man, just, it should have no boundaries.
Because they say it's not natural, it's not the way it should
man,
be.
But to be honest, like, yeah. As I say, like boundaries and boxes are for cereal and boundaries are for fucking chickens. So just love whoever the fuck you want to love and tell the truth and unconditionally love as many people as you can and I think you'll be all right in this world, man. You know what I mean?
We are just waiting for the album now.
Absolutely.
When is it planned?
April. As soon as...
Okay, I can't hear you.
Hey, bro!
Okay!
My teachers always used to say that to me. They used to say, like,
why?
Excitement doesn't mean noise, Dominic.
Well, obviously, you know when your album will be issued.
Hey, bro!
Okay. I told the French audience, I told that Dave Grohl said all the love he had on your music, your material. I mean, it's one of, I mean, for me, Foo Fighters is one of the
same.
Best band in the world.
Same.
And so how did you react when you heard that compliment?
I'm still not over it, to be honest. He came up to me at a show and put his hands around my neck as a joke and was like, ah, and I was just like, I just got strangled by Dave Grohl. What?
So chic.
I was like, so chic. Yeah.
Which artist did you love when you were a young boy? What was it? The Cure, for instance?
Yeah,
David,
I mean,
Bowie?
Yeah, The Cure, definitely. Like, look at me. Do you know what I mean? I loved The Cure. I loved Bowie. I loved Oasis. I love the Libertines. I love Lady Gaga.
I think Pete Doherty is still in Paris.
Yeah, I think he's trapped here.
Yeah.
He's been a very naughty boy.
No, well, he is original me.
Yeah.
He is living his life his way, and sometimes the rules are... I've got a problem with the French rules. Lady Gaga, too.
Absolutely.
Well, she often sing this kind of idea, be yourself, I am what I am. And
absolutely, and that's what really stuck to me. Like, I saw artists like Lady Gaga, and I just was like, she didn't fit a mold.
Mm.
So she just built her own. And I was like, if she can do that, then I can.
You know, at the beginning, she was playing piano in a bar in New York, and nobody was listening to her. She was just playing, and people was blah, 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 chatting, drinking, laughing,
and nobody
cared. And then she began to strip. I mean, she took away one clothes, two clothes, stuff like that, and then, whoa, what happening? Voilà. And she... And,
do you want me to strip? No, is that what you're saying?
Thank you. No, because I'm just listening to you. And what about you singing Lady Gaga's material now?
Oh, yeah, man, I'd love that. I'd love that. This is one of my favorite songs, man. Paparazzi, does anyone know that? We are the crowd and we're cook coming out. Got my flash on, it's true. And a picture of you, it's so magical. We'd be so fantastical. Leather and jeans, garage glamorous. I'm not sure what that means, but that picture of us, it don't have a price. Sitting under those flashing lights, you know the baby, I'm your biggest fan. I'll follow you until you love me. Papa, paparazzi, baby, there's no other superstar. You know that I'll be your papa, paparazzi. Promise I'll be kind, but I won't stop until that boy is mine. Baby, you'll be famous, chase you down until you love me. Papa, paparazzi.
Il s'appelle Youngblood!
Yeah, man!
Je veux juste... Dominic. I just say Dominic because... Youngblood is made of Dominic and your fans and
absolutely.
Your audience. So now I'm just talking to the human being. I just want to tell...
The Dom.
Yeah, the Dom. I just want to tell everybody and our audience and the TV viewers and everybody that your behave right now, tonight, is not a special behave because it's a show, there is camera, there's the audience. You've been like that during the whole day. You've been like that in the rooms. You've been like that on the set. You've been like on the rehearsal. So you're serious, man. You're a real human being. Thank you for being what you
Thank
are.
Thank you for having me, man.
Thank you.
Rock and roll star.
Come back whenever you want.
Mate, whenever
you ask.
You'll have me, man.
Okay? That's
a deal. Je t'aime, baby.